Sí, este sábado será un gran combate, ya nos conocemos y el que salga con ese cinturón sabe que va a conocer el infierno, porque esa pelea no es para menos. Es una pelea en la que no le quede a nadie ninguna duda de que ha habido boxeadores que se van a dejar el alma. Y quería apuntar otra cosa, que en la anterior rueda de prensa no se tradujo literal. Me gustaría que todos ustedes conociesen lo que quiero decir. Me gustaría que este sábado, cuando gane el campeonato del mundo, no se le deje a Charlie como un juguete roto, porque seguirá siendo un gran boxeador. Y quiero y deseo que le sigan dando todas las oportunidades que se merece, aún cuando yo sea campeón del mundo este sábado.
Good luck.
Yes. And well, on Saturday we will have an amazing fight, and I know that the one that comes at the end of the fight with the belt will have gone through hell, because it's going to be the fight of a lifetime. And something else that I would like to mention about the last press conference that maybe wasn't understood as I meant it, is that on Saturday, when I win the world title, don't leave Charlie aside as a broken toy, because he has huge potential, he's a huge fighter. But so keep on supporting him even when I become the champion on Saturday night.
It's very kind of you, Angel. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Angel. Very good fighter, very good solid fight, as you've mentioned before. He could cause a lot of problems. He's got a tricky style, but we've studied it, we've come up with a couple of game plans, and he better get ready.
Charlie?
Regarding on me being a broken toy and stuff like that, talk's cheap, but I understand that he is very hungry, just like I was in my my last press conference before I could become champion. But me winning this world title, it hasn't made me relax anymore. It's made me more determined. I want to go down as a British great, and this is the first step on my journey. If anything, it's made me a better fighter. I'm more confident. I'm more adapting to situations that I never thought I'd be able to adapt to. Things are just clicking left, right and centre, and it feels great. It feels great to be coming and headlining my show in London, and coming out as world champion. These are dreams of that I had from a little boy, laying in bed, going to sleep at night. And the reality is, it's all coming true, and that's from hard work, belief, and faith. I'd just like to say thank you again, Eddie, for this opportunity and believing in me even when I was down. Angel Mourinho is a top-class, world-class fighter. I've shared many rounds with him in the gym, and he is very tough. I wouldn't be surprised if it went the distance, and I've fully prepared for the distance. But then again, I wouldn't be surprised if we got him out of there. We're a completely different animal now. And what Grant has installed into me got me back to basics, got my footwork so much better. I'm planting when I'm hitting my punches. My record doesn't say I'm a puncher, but in my last fight, you see that I kept Rosales off, and you can see what an animal he was. So I must have been gaining respect. So either way, I wouldn't be surprised, but I will say it's going to be a Charlie Edwards win in style, a punch-perfect performance.
Competitive and win the fight with Josh. I think that's my experience will show in the early rounds also, but yeah, he's a fast starter and he gets people out there early, so should be explosive to start with.
But the British title is important for me. I've said many times it's something that I feel I must win on this journey. Conrad has said this is his dream, so he's gonna come. This is a man fighting for his dreams, but Saturday night I'll be there, I'll be present.
I see Woody on social. social media, you know, calling me names, does an interview, so on and so forth. But then when he comes up there, he's very, you know, quiet and respectful. So hopefully he can bring that same energy on social media to the fight, and then we can have a good fight. And I hear him talking about, you know, new team and so on and so forth. So it's good for him that he's, you know, mind's right and stuff. But I hope in the fight as well, when I start landing on him, because I've been working religiously on not holding on the inside. So we're going to go to work. That same mindset stays there and that same spirit stays there. And then we can have a great fight. It doesn't frustrate me because I get to go home, look at myself in the mirror and just be realistic with myself, with where I'm at, what I've done. When I stop and think, you know, I was working at McDonald's, yet somehow I've become an Olympian, somehow I became European champion as an amateur, somehow I've won the British title, somehow I've won the Commonwealth title, somehow I'm in a knockout world ranking match on Saturday. So for me, it's I look at reality as opposed to, you know, what other boxers say, what other fans say, like him talking about wrestling and so on and so forth. I just look at real life, and real life is I'm going to stop Woody Camacho badly on the weekend. 100% I'm in this fight by stoppage. And also I'm going to make some more like prophecies, if I'm allowed to do that now. I think I'm going to stop Woody Camacho. God willing, if I'm able to do that, then as I said before I turn pro, before the end of 2020, even this year, I'm going to world title. That's it, so let's make that happen.
Saturday. Yeah, we should have, you know, me and the team have sat down, we probably should have moved to 140 a good couple of fights ago, but when you're knocking everybody out and on the crest wave, and you know you don't want to, and we're doing stuff that we shouldn't have been doing to make 135, and you know we'll learn the hard way, but we'll be back at 140 and we'll be better.